Mercadolibre, sometimes called the Amazon of Latin America, has delivered 23% gains for investors in 2024. But what will 2025 look like? Will the company deliver similar or better performance in 2025? That's the question I'll answer in this video. I'll make my stock price prediction or stock price target for Mercadolibre stock for the end of 2025, where I think the stock price will end up by the end of next year. I'm going to use the company's earnings per share estimates for 2026 and the forward price to earnings ratio to make this stock price target. I'll share with you where I'm getting the numbers from. I'm going to do several different scenarios so you can tell for yourself whether or not my base case or my estimate is on point, too high or too low. Let's take a look.
Hey everyone, I want to take a moment to thank the sponsor of this video. Moomoo is a trading platform where you can buy and sell stocks and other investments. I use the platform for investing myself. If you join using the link in my description, you can get up to 15 free stocks.
So like I highlighted, the stock price is up 23% year to date in 2024. And one of the numbers I'm going to need to make my stock price estimate is Mercadolibre's forward price to earnings ratio, which stands at 42. I also need Mercadolibre's earnings per share estimate for fiscal year 2026. And according to the Wall Street analysts that are following Mercadolibre stock, they forecast the company will deliver $63.26 in EPS in 2026. Remember, nobody knows for sure what's going to happen in the future, but the Wall Street analysts that are following the stock have relationships with management where management tells them information that helps them make this estimate for where they think earnings per share will be. And so the Wall Street analysts have good access to information to make these earnings per share estimates. And that's why I utilize them when making my stock price targets. Now, the analysts on Wall Street do expect Mercadolibre to demonstrate excellent earnings per share growth, not just for the next couple of years, but also longer term. And part of the reason for that is because the Latin American economy is not as developed as the US economy, and growth in the company's e-commerce segment, where Mercadolibre has a strong market share, it's growing faster than in the United States. So there's a greater tailwind in that region from people shifting their spending online, going from in-person to online. That shift is growing faster in Latin America than it is in the United States because we're further along in that development. So those are some of the reasons why Mercadolibre is expected to grow its earnings per share robustly over the next several years. All right, so now that we have the numbers we need to make our stock price estimate, we can go ahead and jump into the model. So here we have the 2026 earnings per share estimate of $63 and the forward PE expectation of 42. If everything else remains the same, then the stock price could end up at $2,656 per share by the end of next year. That's if the company is on track to hit this earnings per share estimate and the forward PE multiple remains at 42. Now, that would be a nice increase from the current share price of $1,929 per share. And I've embedded the Google Finance formula in this cell here, so it will update the company's current market price every 20 minutes during trading hours. Those of you that are members at the investor tier, you get access to this spreadsheet and you can see all of my stock price estimates and my stock price targets, as well as my buy, hold, or sell recommendations. If you're interested in getting access, you can join as a member at the investor tier. Now, I don't think Mercadolibre's forward PE ratio remains at 42 next year. I think the forward PE ratio is likely to move lower. And if it moves all the way down to 35, the stock price could still rise, but a little bit lower to $2,200 per share. If the forward PE multiple were to decrease to 30, then the stock price would be relatively flat at $1,900 per share. If the forward PE falls more dramatically down to 25, then the stock price could fall all the way down to $1,581 per share. So you can see $1,000 of differential here based on the scenarios I've analyzed for Mercadolibre stock. Based on the forward PE multiple, you can experience this wide range of outcome. But where is my base case? Where do I think is the most likely scenario? I think it's a forward PE between somewhere around 40 and 35. Or in other words, if I was to put a range here for the stock price, I would say somewhere between $2,200 per share and $2,400 per share by the end of next year. As you can see, I'm forecasting a considerable upside here for Mercadolibre stock. Remember, there is risk associated with these forecasts and with these predictions. These are just my calculations, and I encourage you all to do your own due diligence and don't take these numbers to be precise. These are more ranges, estimates, assumptions here, and there's a lot of uncertainty when you're dealing with estimates and assumptions. So caution to be undertaken here when evaluating a stock using all of these estimates. Still, if you're interested in learning more about my stock price predictions and estimates, you can subscribe to the channel. I do these kinds of videos all the time, and then you can get access to these spreadsheets through a membership at the investor tier.
Hey everyone, if you like watching my videos, then I've added a great complimentary product just for you. I've created a book, I've written a book that's available for sale now that highlights my 6-step investing framework. Even if you don't follow that investing framework, just reading it and knowing how I evaluate stocks will make it a lot more interesting and informative to watch my videos. I've added the link in the description below.